Christ, and I'm reliving the New Testament. I have experienced it before. It's like in a theme park, where you go on this slide with a group of people, and you are taken down this fantastic ride through hell, where at the end awaits a steel rotating saw that is pressed against your jugular, and you're all cut into bloody pieces, along with everybody else, on a big processing conveyor belt, like in a factory. Only, I'm not sure if it's real or not, and I go on the ride anyway, because it seems like fun. But then, I'm not sure if at the end there will really be a fake blade, or if we will all get cut into bloody pieces. But this has a sense of destiny. Like, I could save Christ and retell the story by not getting on this ride. But Christ did get on. It was fated. And he chose to. And if he didn't choose to, there would be no resurrection. I step onto the slides, and we all slide down with one big swoop. No turning back. It feels incredible. Though I'm not sure if it will actually get processed and chopped into bloody pieces or not. I keep anticipating the false or real axe dropping against my jugular. I go through these gates. They swing open, and we go into a barn, where I see cages to my left and right that are full of rabbits, I think. There are all sorts of assistants working there, wearing black pants and white sweaters. They seem very forbidding, like I'm not supposed to touch anything or do anything. But in spite of that, I throw all caution into the wind and look more closely at the rabbits as the red swoops through. I even grab a girl's buttocks. She's annoyed. I feel good. Because if I'm going to die at the end of the ride anyways, I keep going. I don't know when the blade is going to drop, but we keep sliding forwards. I feel swept up in this ride. I can't get off. And I really don't know what to expect. I'm afraid. But I cross the gates and the dark jaws into the next adventure.
I was in hell. Hell was busy. Devils with mummy faces and bleeding hooves were buzzing about lemons-like, throwing clients into the blazing fire of a giant oven, chomping off the pervert's heads, sewing off their genitals, and dancing in primeval rite of passage, whacking around the severed body parts. Candles, dildos, and needles towered over sinners like Manhattan skyscrapers, merry-go-round like pinwheels, slowly turned mincing sinners. Tank-sized threat traps crawled after their victims, clicking and clacking. A giant lemon, no, a rat, raced after me, and I was not me anymore. I was Mistress Rose, an Amazon warrior, clad in red vinyl. I had a razor in one hand, and a whip in the other, and I fought the rat like a delirious porn cartoon nutcracker. And as the sky tunes boomed with the rave party force, the rat bit me. Teased like daggers, I felt piercing pain, and I knew it was Mistress Rose's pain, and the devil's pain. bourbon's mane and the red's paint. I screamed and slashed and smacked. I sliced the red's throat and stood knee deep in the boiling black blood and shit. The stench got so bad, I couldn't breathe. And as I placed my spy heel on the rat, with one precise sand move, I cut out my red, red heart and pinned it to a blank page in an open book that was bigger than me. $1 million red, swollen and shiny hard, I watched the blood flowing from it, forming final writing on the white of the page. I woke up screaming with a sharp pain in my chest. Hell, in Mistress Rose's dream, is the representation of both their dungeon and her life. She has a choice, either to continue acting out her childhood traumas, penis envy, and unresolved Oedipus complex, violate her taboos, keep working in sex industry, or to keep suppressing her conflict but remain torn and neurotic. In either case, she finds herself in hell.
My God.
Rose's hell is reminiscent of George Eliot's version of hell. What is hell? Hell is oneself. Hell is alone.